Hello everyone, after finishing structure of DNA in previous session in this lecture series on genetics and molecular biology, I welcome you to the next session, which is the sixth session in this entire lecture series. I am Dr. Yogesh Pavade. I recommend you to subscribe to the channel so that you get the notifications of upcoming videos in real time and you will not miss any video. The same competency we are dealing with, BI 7.1, the structure and functions of DNA and RNA and the cell cycle. After finishing the structure of DNA, now we are moving on to structure of mRNA, that is messenger RNA. The specific learning objectives of this session are, at the end of the session, phase 1 MBBS student shall be able to describe structure of messenger RNA. The messenger RNA is one of the types of RNA, but it is the most heterogeneous class of RNA with respect to its size and stability. The molecular weight of messenger RNA varies from 3 into 10 to the power 4 to 2 into 10 to the power 6. So its variation is wide. mRNAs consist of 10 to the power 3 to 10 to the power 4 ribonucleotides, mainly adenine, guanine, cytosine and uracil. Adenine, guanine, cytosine here and uracil. The thymine in DNA is replaced by uracil in RNA. Methylpurines and methylpyrimidines are minor bases which are found in RNA, which are not found in DNA, but these are the derived purines and pyrimidines are present in RNAs. The mRNA molecules are formed with the help of DNA template strand during the process called as transcription. And the template strand has a polarity of 3 prime to 5 prime end. And this we have discussed detail in the previous session. If you still have any confusion about that, we can go back to the previous video in this lecture series, that is video on structure of DNA. Here the mRNA molecule are formed with the help of DNA template strand during the process called as transcription. The mRNA carries a specific sequence of nucleotides in triplets. So the sequence is present in the form of triplets, which are called as codon. We will learn this topic on codon in detail in subsequent sessions. You just understand that the specific sequence of nucleotides in triplet in a set of 3 is called as codon, and it is responsible for the synthesis of a specific protein. But this mRNA, when it comes to cytosol for protein synthesis, it has to undergo lot of processing, and it is the final product of transcription. The mRNA has to undergo lot of processing. And what is the precursor of mRNA? The precursor of mRNA is heteronuclear RNA, or simply hnRNA. This hnRNA is bound to macromolecular proteins called as informophores and exist as heterogeneous ribonuclear protein, that is called as hnRNP. Half life of hnRNA is 23 minutes. It usually contains 400 to 4000 nucleotides and 10 to 100 times bigger than mRNA. 75% of hnRNA degraded in the nucleus. So without getting converted into mRNA, 75% of hnRNA is degraded in the nucleus. Only 25% of hnRNA forms a precursor of mRNA, that is pre-mRNA. So this is an intermediate between hnRNA and mRNA. So 25% of hnRNA is getting converted into pre-mRNA. And this pre-mRNA will be later on converted to messenger RNA. This pre-mRNA has regions, introns and exons. So intron transcripts and exon transcripts. Introns are approximately 80% of the total pre-mRNA structure. And exons actually are only 20% of the structure of pre-mRNA. The exons transcripts are spliced to form mRNA. This is the structure of mRNA. In this particular structure, if you can see here, the actual coding region is from the start site to stop site. Before that, there is 5' UTR, that is untranslated region. And after the stop site, where the stop codon will be there, there is 3' UTR, means 3' untranslated region. And at the end of 3' untranslated region, you will see the 3' poly A tail. So poly A means polyadenylate tail, and before this 5 prime UTR you will see 7 methyl guanosine triphosphate cap. 7 methyl guanosine triphosphate cap at 5 prime OH end of the mRNA. And here 3 prime OH end carries poly A tail, and in this poly A tail almost 20 to 250 adenylate ribonucleotides are usually seen. And what is the significance of poly A tail and 5 prime 7 methyl guanosine triphosphate cap? This poly A tail maintains the intracellular stability of mRNA by preventing the attack of 3 prime exonucleases. And this 7 methyl guanosine triphosphate cap is involved in recognition of protein biosynthesis machinery. So without this 5 prime cap, you know, the ribosome cannot identify the mRNA for protein biosynthesis. And along with that, from the attack of 5 prime exonucleases, this 5 prime methyl cap will save this mRNA. From the attacks of 5 prime exonucleases and 3 prime exonucleases, the 7 methyl guanosine triphosphate cap and 3 prime poly A tail are, you know, saving the mRNA. Otherwise, it will get degraded by the exonucleases, both by 5 prime, from the 5 prime end and from the 3 prime end, by these 5 prime exonucleases and 3 prime exonucleases. And this 7 methyl guanosine triphosphate cap, after identification of mRNA by the ribosome system or assembly, begins protein synthesis at 5 prime end of the capped structure of mRNA, this particular coding region. The template strand of DNA is transcribed into a single stranded mRNA, that we have seen, and this is accomplished by DNA dependent RNA polymerase. So RNA polymerase synthesizes RNA depending on template strand of DNA. So DNA dependent RNA polymerase, it's a complementary copy of the template strand of DNA. And in the DNA, one strand will harbor certain genes while others are borne by the other strand. A transcription unit is the region of DNA that includes not only the gene for mRNA synthesis, but also the initiator, promoter, terminator regions, as well as the introns. And the mRNA that is initially produced is called as primary transcript. This was all regarding mRNA. And these are the literature which I have used to prepare presentations in this lecture series. You can refer to these references for further studies. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching the video. If you really like the content, please like, share and subscribe to the channel. Please don't forget to hit the bell button and making all notifications available to you so that you do not miss any upcoming video. Keep watching, keep learning, and keep motivating us. Thank you so much.